Vaygrim's chance. Welcome to Life in the Buffer.
Alrighty. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Sorry I am a little bit late this evening. Just real life stuffs. Ended up working a little late tonight. And so that set me a little bit behind, which still that little bit late working meant that dinner was a little later and going to the gym was a little later. And anyway, yeah, things just have a way of working out that way. But here I am, and for some reason, let's see, my preview, what's going on here? OBS is giving me a little grief here. It was showing me the Minecraft screen. In fact, I saw it streaming there. Let me try resetting something here. Let's just try. I'm going to turn off that, and we're going to try recapturing Minecraft. Let's see how that does. Oh, it looks like it should put us back again. Alright, now hopefully that sticks. So, Dragon Racer 73. How are things this evening? I assume it's evening in your part of the world. I'm not sure which part of the world you're in, actually. I'm going to turn down that music, is what I'm going to do. Sure, it's a little bit loud. There we go. That's probably more tolerable levels. All right. Well, let's see if anything changed here. Looks like our little Vaygrim slave is still sieving away in there. Looks like he's working on gravel right now. Wisconsin. Yeah, all right. So you're in the central time zone. I'm out west in the Pacific. Boing. Got plenty of cannoli going here. This is Preacher's tree farm that he set up. What do we got here? That's working. Looks like we got some woods coming there. All right. So it looks like nothing really changed too much. I'm never sure how much Preach or Ferg are going to be on between sessions. I thought I saw someone else was on. Oh yeah, Craig Place is on. Let's see if he's actually paying attention or if he's AFK. And I'm going to join into the LP chat channel in case anyone else wants to join in over at Vaygrim, the Vaygrim Discord. All right, so we're pretty much good to go this evening. Thanks for popping in, Dragon Racer. So I'm thinking tonight, first I'm going to actually go check over the mob farm and see if everything's all right over there. Because it tends to get pretty compacted. gotcha. No problems. It is late. You know, it's only, you know, a little after 8 here on the West Coast, but it's pretty late everywhere else. It's a really kind of a tough slot that I've got here. It's really not a very good streaming slot. If I were to try to do this, you know, professionally or whatever, not a very good time slot because it's so late for, you know, the East Coast and everything. And even, you know, like Europe, right? The time zones that are going to be good for me would be like Pacific, but it's a little early for Pacific even, so it's just really kind of a bad slot. But I must just not geographically blessed that way. But if you're in the East or the Midwest, then you know you do pretty well because you can hit prime time in multiple time zones there. All right. So what I was thinking is really just sort of a cosmetic kind of thing. Oh, what's going on here? So we're at half. Oh, I guess that's just normal. It's just sort of a cosmetic thing. Instead of, you know, having all of our power just kind of stuffed in over in this one little corner, I was thinking about putting all of the canola oil stuff over here, the press, and even like maybe building a tank over here. And then I just pipe it back over here to the power station over here. Hey, Craig. I just thought you were online. So are you online and also in Beam right now? Double dipping. Mall Rat, welcome. So I thought maybe I would build a tinker tank over here, which is I don't know when tinker tanks started showing up, but I was talking to Dragon Racer is hosting the channel. Thanks for the host, Dragon Racer. Appreciate that. Yeah, well, you know, I usually I've been streaming Tuesday evenings, usually with Ferg and with Dark Preacher. And this is kind of our time to work the island here, the Dark Sanctuary, we've been calling it. And but tonight, though, Ferg, he's got a birthday to tend to, not his, but his wife's birthday. And Dark Preacher, he's just kind of taking the evening off. I think he's maybe catching up on some stuff. He's gotten ahead in his Let's Plays, and I think he's trying to sort of catch up on stuff. using his body as a chunk loader. Yeah, let's see. How are the deaths, by the way? We can check the server stats here. Server info. That's not what I want. Oh, yeah, that was what I wanted. Server info, leaderboards. Let's see. Deaths per hour. Number of deaths. Let's see who we've got here. So we've got, oh yeah, Craig, you charged out ahead there. Nicely done. Trunks there had a pretty firm grasp on the lead position. But you have sprinted out ahead. Congratulations. Yeah. Right after him is Super Dave. And then there's Trunks. And then, boy, you guys are like, you know, you've basically lapped everyone else. Because we've got, you know, Vaygrim back here at 8. And everyone else is kind of out in the same spot. That is, except for me. Down here at 2, me and Flame Effect. But Flame Effect hasn't ever really been on very, very much. Ferg is at Chuck E. Cheese. Happy birthday, Ferg! No, it is not Ferg's birthday, but yeah. Anyway, how are we doing over here? Last time I walked by here, this was stuck on, and there was like cobblestone spewing everywhere, but we're doing all right now. We have lavas coming into here now. Yeah, it's all full. All right, cool. I just like to walk around and check stuff because, you know, you just never know when you walk away for a little bit and come back what you know, stuff's going to look like. I have cobbles, you know, strewn all over the floor and monsters running amok. I wear the non-death as a badge of honor. Yeah, you know, I kind of do too. I actually do try to not die in the game. Yeah, it is kind of an honorable thing, I guess. I mean, there's not really any penalty to it, right? But I don't know. I guess it's just the idea of the thing. So let's see. How are we doing here for our ingots here? All right, that's a pretty healthy collection of ingots. We got a whole bunch of osmium, way more osmium than we'll be using. Same with copper. Tin, yeah, same thing there. Iron, we do use a lot of that, but we've still got 1,100 of that. But we are set, actually, when it comes to ingots. Ooh, diamonds. We don't have too many diamonds, though. I guess that's why our Vaygrim bot upstairs is sieving away at the gravel. Oh, Effect has been having issues with the pack and his PC. Oh, so is the pack putting too much strain on his PC? Is that what it is? Or is it some sort of weird, like, you know, Java kind of error? Oh, really? Huh. So, I'm surprised how low on diamonds we are. Oh, well, those 7 here. waiting to be turned into blocks. That's part of it, I guess. The these X-Compressum auto-compressors had a glitch for a while. I think it got fixed with this most recent version that we just updated to. Whereas before, what would happen, and that's part of the reason why we have four of these out here, is because what would happen is once the input side would fill up, then anything getting piped into the compressor would then go into the output side, which is wrong. And it wouldn't like jam anything up, but what would happen is it would go into the output side, and then the indoor I.O. conduits, or whatever you're using to move items, the indoor I.O. conduits in this case, would then just pump them right back out again and put them into here, and so you'd end up with like, you know, dust and gravel and stuff that should have been compressed, but because it got pumped into the output side, it got, you know, outputted into the chest, and so we'd end up with you know, random bits and pieces of stuff that should have gotten compressed would be in weird places in the system. But I'm pretty sure, looking at the patch notes for X-Compressum, that the author has fixed that. Couldn't even get vanilla to load. Wow. Huh. Well, that's pretty bad. And that's kind of unusual, too. I mean, Minecraft is kind of finicky sometimes, and it's not, you know, optimized for Java, but still, just not loading at all. Even vanilla is pretty unusual. Sorry, I was getting my tea ready here. I usually have all this stuff ready to go, but like I said, I did say I'm running late, right? The tea this evening is ginger ginger lemon, in case you're wondering. The tea you're listening to me sipping is ginger lemon this evening. Okay, so, oh, anyway, I was talking about tanks is what I was talking about. So, yeah, I thought I would put a tank over here and the canola processing over here in the corner. And I was chatting with Vaygrim the other day, and I was mentioning that I wanted to do a tank-y kind of thing. But I didn't want to do mechanism tanks, because I've done mechanism tanks all over the place. And I didn't think that it really looked like, you know, sort of thematically, like it went along with what we're doing here. To have this sort of tech-y looking mechanism tank over there in the corner. So I wanted something that was kind of more industrial looking, kind of like what we would see with hang on a second, someone's telling me something here. So like what we would see with like railcraft, that kind of thing. Greater C is saying something here. Something seems wrong, tried refreshing. It looks like Greater C is having problems with Beam. Not sure what's going on, but obviously we've got other people in here. We've got four other people in the stream right now. Let me just pop out something to Greater C really quick here. Yeah, so I was looking for something more industrial-y looking. Well, five, yeah, but I think that includes me. I've got my stream up here on another PC right now, so I can see what it looks like when it's beamed out. So that's cheating. Oh, wait, no, okay, now it is. Now I see seven, so you're right. Hey, Vaygrim, how you doing, buddy? I was actually just talking about you. Is it kind of one of those, like one of those things that when you say a demon's name, you summon them from wherever they happen to be? It's a good thing I didn't say, like, you know, Asmodeus or something like that. But so yeah, what I was saying was I was asking Vaygrim before Vaygrim popped in here about ideas for tanks, because I didn't want to do a mechanism tank, and he suggested the Tinker tank, and that's when I said something like Tinker has a tank. And he probably responded back with something snarky. I can't remember what it was, but yeah, Tinker does have a tank, oddly enough. And so I thought I would make the Tinker tanks. I messed with it in single player for a little bit, and it looks kind of cool. It's not, you know, real industrial looking, you know, like the railcraft, you know, iron and steel tanks were, but certainly more so than mechanism is. And so I thought I'd put that together tonight. I intended on putting together all the pieces, off screen, and then constructing it all while everyone was watching. But since I was kind of late this evening, then I'm gonna have to do it on screen. Let's see. So I guess Greylock is a demon, because I mentioned Craig. He shows up. Yeah, boy, I guess I've just got, there must be some sort of sorcery going on here, because as soon as we mention someone's name, they seem to appear in the channel. Alright, so for the Tinker Tank, let's see if I can figure out how to put it together here. This is going to be totally me stumbling through it, and backseat driving is totally appropriate. That's totally fine. I don't mind that. I don't need to stumble through it. Okay, so let's see here. It is a tank something. It's like a seared tank, I think is what it is. And a tank controller is the important piece. It's not the seared tank, because that's what we use for the smeltery. But I know they need a tank controller, so I'm gonna have to make some of this. Tinker's Steelworks has a tank. Yeah, but there is a tank here. I did put it together in a single player. And where is it? Is it this? Not pressurized. It's mechanisms tank. Where is it here? RF2s, no. Tinker tank controller. Is it fluid tank, dynamic tank? Come on, where is it here? I told you I'd be stumbling through this, right? I did warn you. All right, what is it called here? That's the pressure pipes. Let's try at Ender.io. Yeah, but is it just called Tinker Tank? Is that what it is? I don't think that's it. There's a Tinker Tank controller, but the tank itself is called something else. Hey, Fergcraft, thanks for the follow. Appreciate it. There is the seared tank, but that's actually the tank that holds the lava for the smeltery, right? See, there's a seared gauge, seared tank, seared window, the seared glass, that's what it is. I think it's actually the seared glass. Oh, you know what? Here, let's do this. Let's just pop over to my single player world, and I've got everything all set up over there. Uh-oh, missing blocks! Oh no! Oh, those are actually Ender.io blocks. Now, wouldn't it be funny if the tank was no longer part of this version of Ender.io? And by funny, I mean... Oh, there it is. Okay, see, here it is. So, seared glass. Alright, so it's seared glass and the Tinker Tank controller, right? So, total spoiler here. This is what I want the tank to end up looking like right here. So, like I said, it's a little bit more industrial. Not so industrial as Railcraft is, but it's a little more industrial than, say, you know, mechanism tanks and that kind of thing. Yes, I think if I remember right, I think Vaygrim pointed me toward page 88 in the manual, I think is what he did. So let's see. If I remember correctly. Sure enough, there it is. 88. Tinker Tank. Yep. That Vaygrim always seemed to have a snappy answer, like he's done this kind of thing before. Yeah, so that's it. So you make it out of seared glass, and the bottom is just these seared bricks, and then the drains work exactly the way they do on a smeltery. And you can basically make the walls out of pretty much anything you want. I think the corners have to be glass, but you can put the middle of the walls anything you want. I thought this looked kind of neat, having the seared brick there. And then the top can be several different things. It can be like the slabs or even the stairs, if you want it to be. But I just thought I'd go with the seared bricks. I might do slabs maybe, because it might look a little snappier. Let's see what the slabs actually look like here. Search. Let's see. Fancy seared bricks slab. There's a lot of sibilance there. Seared tabs. And then it starts raining. Let's see what this tile looks like. Go away, rain! Yeah, so it's kind of cool. I mean, you can make the tops of all kinds of different, you know, tinkers materials. I'm not sure I care for that pattern, but I do kind of like the smaller cap on the top, though. Ferg, what are you doing here anyway? I thought you had like a birthday to celebrate. What's up with that? I mean, I'm glad that you're here, buddy, but I thought you'd be busy, you know, all night long. We're gonna keep this a family show, but you know. Happy birthday and everything. Yes, and the mechanism things there, they are a little bit plastic. I know exactly what you mean by that. And it has sort of a tech plasticky look. And if you've got a tech build, then you know that actually works. But for this sort of an industrial kind of a build, yeah, I don't think that works all that well. Bing. Yeah, that looks pretty cool. Don't you think? I think. You don't see plasticky? No, I mean the mechanism tank. Not the Tinker's tank, but the mechanism tank. We were comparing this to the mechanism one. Gotcha. Well, why don't you join in? Why don't you hop in, Ferg? Unless it'll be too loud. We don't want to keep her awake or whatever. But yeah, so this is the look that I'm going to end up going for. So help me remember here. So we've got the seared glass, and the rest is the regular seared bricks, and the Tinker Tank controller is where all the magic is. And you can put its, setup for metals, for molten metals in here. You can see that it even measures everything in ignits. And if you want to look at it in buckets, you have to actually hold down the button, held down the shift button, to see it in buckets. But it does work. Works really well. I think it looks pretty cool too. And we'll have to see how it, how it sucks up my FPSs. That's always the danger with these sorts of things, right? In that, whenever you've got some sort of a live, you know, dynamic thing here, then it's inevitably going to be using some of your FPSs, whether it's fluid in a clear tank or whether it's, icons in the front of your storage drawers, but it's going to suck up some of your FPSs, and there's just no way around it. Oh, Ferg. Yeah, you know, I just build them and you pretty them. We've kind of got a little thing going, actually. It seems to work pretty well. I'm going to swap back to the Vaygrim's Chance server here. And of course, it's raining here. Look what happened. I disappear for a little bit, and it starts to rain. Okay, so I need... Oh, Dragon Racer's on. Okay, so I need to make some seared glass is what I need, right? No, it was seared glass. And that's, is that just... Okay, so that's seared bricks and the quite clear glass. Or any glass, really. Interiode just popped in there. So I gotta make seared bricks, though. And that is grout. Boy, see, I haven't made tinker stuff in so long. I usually don't do much with the tinker stuff. Because it seems like you do all this work into making your tank and getting that all set up, and then you make all these little forms, these little templates and everything, and then you make like one weapon and that's it, and you never really touch it again. And honestly, I just usually make the atomic disassembler and then I'm done until they skip past the whole tinker thing. I am grout. So grout is just gravel and sand and clay. All right, we can do that. Let's go make ourselves some grout. I am grout. I am grout. Grout. Let's see. Oh, here we go. Grout. I should have taken count of how many grouts I was gonna need, but I just wasn't that with it. When you cast the seared stone, it'll make bricks. Yeah. What is this thing? It says you can just melt cobblestone in the smeltery. Are you talking about Mallrat just, what does the cobblestone in the smeltery make? If I just put cobblestone in the smeltery, does it make something? I am Grouch. It's a bug. Oh, really? So if I put you're telling me if I put cobblestone in the smeltery, I get seared bricks out of it? Really? I didn't even know that. I started to just, like, make them. Huh. Did not know that. So is that going to be faster, you think, than making them manually like I started to do it? Because I've got a ton of cobbly stones. All right. Oh, man. Starting to, like, totally thunder and everything. Bloop. All right, we're going to start making us some cobble. And I'm going to want to cast that to a ignite, which I guess is already here. All right. Well, so I'll take your word for it that it's going to be faster this way than just crafting them. How about this rain, huh? Actually, it's been raining like this in Southern California, too. Really crazy. I'm kind of done with it. I mean, it's nice and everything, because we certainly needed the rain, but I'm kind of over it now. Also melt the compressed cobblestone. What happens if I melt compressed cobblestone in the smeltery? Oh man, it's important dumping it out here. I didn't want that! I want it here! Oh, look at this! Look at that, right there! Bam! Seared brick! Okay, so I put compressed cobblestone in there, and I just get 9 times the amount of whatever that I would if I had to put just cobblestone in there. Alright, that is pretty fast, actually. I mean, not like I doubted you, I'm just, you know, commenting. Seared stone is what I get if I make a block of it. Yeah, I probably should. But see, I don't have the anything over here to suck up the bricks. Like what's on the I don't know what you call that thing over there that makes the blocks. So then to make my glass, what was that? That was one glass in the middle and then 4 seared bricks, right? That seems like it's going to take a lot of time. Is there a faster way to make seared glass or that's it? So it looks like can I just put glass in here and get seared glass out of it? That's what it looks like here to me, right? Consumes cast. Oh, it consumes the cast. What? How can that be? Chiseled the seared stone to a brick type. Oh, huh. Yeah. But the seared glass, though, it seems like what that was just telling me is that if I cast glass in here, that it turns into seared glass. You pour the stone on top of the glass. So I would put glass in, and then dump it in here, and then put stone on top of it, and that would give me seared glass. I don't know if that would be any faster or not. Interesting. Well, I must hand it to the Tinker's Construct guys. You can do a lot with this smeltery. and I really want a timer on this thing right now, but see, now, like I said, I was going to do all this off camera, but I just didn't have time to set that up. And then you wouldn't be watching me smelting bricks. Let's see how I'm set up with glass here. I don't have a lot. I can craft a bunch, though. Let's make an even stack. Oh, 94. Don't need that much. Let's make an even stack out of it. Available. That's all good. Start. Crafting. Look at me craft. Watch me now. Wow, that storm is not going away anytime soon. All right, so who here is going to PAX? South or East, I guess. When is PAX East? I've been focusing on PAX South, because that's when I'm going to. But I know PAX East is coming up pretty soon, right? Yeah, well, see, I'll be there Thursday late, like 11 or 11:30, something like that. So probably won't see you then, but I will be at the East is in March. Huh, okay. Yeah, I'll be at the show on Friday, though. They need a PAX North. Yeah, there's just the West, which is really Northwest, because it's Seattle, right? And then, yeah, they should have one in North, like maybe like Chicago or something like that, right? Or maybe even Canada. They could have PAX Canada. But yeah, Chicago would probably be good, because you'd catch... and East is Northeast. Where is the PAX East? I don't even know. PAX Maple. Sorry if I'm bouncing around a little bit. My mouse sensitivity is set a little high. Minnesota. Yeah, that'd be good. A little further west than Chicago. How am I doing on bricks here? 32 bricks. Boston is where PAX East is. That makes sense. But it is still pretty northeast, though. Boston. Get some of this cooking while I'm baking bricks here. Like the Hebrews in Egypt, making bricks without straw. Yeah, I'm looking forward to PAX. I mean, the show is going to be great. But mostly, you know, what I'm really looking forward to is meeting all these peoples that I've been interacting online with for so long. Some of these people for literally years. And never actually met in person, but you know, you feel like you know them because you've messed with them online so much. You've you sort of gotten to know them online, but you know, to actually meet them, it's going to be pretty cool. And then there's a couple of panels, sessions, meetings, whatever you want to call it, that I'm going to on. Oh, there goes the rain. I'm going to on Friday. Mostly community oriented things, because that's really what one of the things that I really enjoy about. Gaming is the sense of community, really, is what it is. You know, the League of Ordinary Gamers, of course, but the Beam community, for example, is an extended community, because the Beam community, they really tend to support each other here. more so than, I mean, you'd think they'll be the same, but it really isn't, and I'm not sure why that is, but there's just a different feeling here. But anyway, I was just, you know, talking about the community feel. That's one of the things that I really enjoy about gaming like this, is getting online and doing stuff together with people. It gives you a chance to meet some people that you would not normally end up rubbing elbows with, physical or virtual or otherwise. And you get the chance to meet doing something, some sort of common task, like, you know, building a floating island in the sky. And yeah, it's kind of cool meeting different people like that. So there's a couple of community-oriented meetings on Friday. One at 10:30, which is actually more about the streaming community and how to build a community for your channel, basically, which I'm not so much interested in. It's sort of tangential to my interest. I'm mostly interested in just the community thing, and that happens to be a community streaming thing. But then later on at, I think 4 or 4:30, something like that, is actually a panel talking about the sort of extended communities in the gaming community and building those communities. So really looking forward to that. Let's go ahead and build some of the seared glass here. I'm getting bored making bricks. I don't know about you, but I'm getting bored making bricks. I've got some glass here. I've got some more that was being constructed down here for me. Ooh, hello. A little glitch there. I was wondering what Dragon Racer was doing in there. Where are you hanging out, Dragon Racer? Oh, he must be working on the next season stuff, or this season part two stuff is what he's doing. So yeah, that's hush-hush stuff. You did not hear that from me! Okay, so what was I doing? I was going to make some seared glass. Not in Gauss, glass. Oh, is there a way to make a whole bunch of this? I can just actually make it all here. I get a whole bunch of glass. Let's just get all the glasses. All the glass. I made it all for me anyway, so I'm just going to take it all. And put it all here, and then all my bricks. Bloop, bloop, bloop. Now I should be able to make, what is that, like 13 bricks? All right, nice. All right, now let's see if there happen to be any more of those. Can I do something with seared stone? Can I turn that back into bricks again? No. I wonder if I can maybe chisel it back into that or something. Let's see if there happens to be any more seared. There doesn't. No seared in the inventory. All right, so I need to make seared bricks. Now you were telling me just the... actually, if I put 4 bricks together, I can get one of those seared blocks. Isn't that what these are here? What is it? That's made of that. That's a controller. Boop-a-doo. If I put 4 of these together, I get, what is it called? It's called the seared... It's not a brick, but it's called a seared block. Is that what it is? Like I said, I'm just a kind of a tinker noob, really. Back into the smelter. You know, that would make sense. Re-smeltify it as soon as I get some space there in the smeltery. So if I do this with it, then I get seared bricks out of it. Yeah, okay. So the base of the tank has to be seared brick. So I'm going to need 9 of those. But the top can be the slabs, so that's going to use a little less material. And again, I apologize for making bricks. Oh, goodness. This is a tedious process, I will admit. Not that that surprises anyone. Is there space in here yet? Not quite yet, almost. What am I doing on lavas? Still full, probably doing alright. Not that. How about that? There we go, now I can put that seared stone in there and smelt that. Could be mining, yeah. That's true. You know, it's funny, I remember, back when I first started playing Minecraft, which was, I don't know, beta 1.2 or something like that. You know, it's funny, or I guess it's probably the same for vanilla Minecraft, but, you know, so much of your time is actually spent mining. Modded Minecraft, it's just like, you know, you very rarely ever mine for stuff, you know. I guess you mine, like, at the very beginning until you start to get your automated systems and whatnot set up. And then if you ever have to mine, it's just like, oh my gosh, I have to mine. Oh, this is terrible. But then in vanilla, you do that, like, all the time. It's like a large portion of your game is just, you know, mining, making holes.
Yay.
Hey, Ferg! Let me make sure that you're piped in here, Ferg. I'm going to do a quick little, some settings over here on OBS. Make sure you're piped in. Say something, Ferg.
Say something, Ferg.
All right, yeah, you're there.
Yay!
Yay! So, how was the birthday celebration? You guys go out to dinner or something, or what? I mean, you don't have to, you know, get too personal or anything, but...
No, we just kind of did that. Because, she's had some insurance issues.
I gotcha. All right. So you had just a quiet evening? That's nice.
Yep.
Cool. I know sometimes that's just the best, actually. Just find a quiet spot to relax.
I'm a homebody.
You gonna pop into the game, or are you just gonna hang out chat? Okay.
I had to wait for it to update. I didn't update it.
Oh, really? Okay.
Now I'm loading it, so that'll be another, like, 10 minutes.
It does take a little while to load, yeah. You know, I wish that there was... It seems like there should be some way to... Like, once you get all the mods loaded, to, like, save that snapshot, right? Almost like a, you know, like a virtualized server, you know, how you basically save a snapshot of the server. Save a snapshot of all the programs that are loaded... And then instead of having to load all those mods in one by one again, you just, like, load that memory snapshot.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
Because a lot of the... I mean, it does a ton of work. I don't know if you've ever, you know, watched the console spew or the, you know, logs that come out of it. But it does a ton of work as it's loading those mods, inventorying all the textures and all the items and all the entities and all that kind of stuff. So if you could just, like, do that once, and then, you know, the downside would be that you can't change anything, right? If you change anything config-wise or mod-wise or anything, you have to, you know, reload it from scratch again. But it just seems to me that if you don't change anything, that you should be able to reload that sort of memory profile again. I don't know, maybe I'm crazy.
You have to wait for it to download, and then you have to wait for it to load again.
Yeah, right, exactly, yeah. It just seems, you know, redundant. And counterproductive.
But hacks.
But hacks, yeah.
Hacks. Hacks. You know that thing we're going to on Thursday.
Packs. Yeah.
Packs.
Which days are you going to be there? Saturday, I assume, because we've got that League of Ordinary Gamers dinner. I'm sure you wouldn't miss that.
I'm there the whole weekend. The sucky part is my flight leaves on Monday at 6 in the morning.
Oh, wow. Yeah, so Mallrat asks, how would you tell if it had changed? Yeah, you know, you'd have to do like some sort of hash. That would be the first thing it would do. It would like run a hash on what was loaded. And yeah, I don't know. I'm sure there'd be some way you could figure it out. And it would be probably quicker to run a hash against what needs to get loaded, compare that against what did get loaded. And if the two are different, then you'd have to start from scratch and reload everything again, right? It wouldn't even attempt to piece it together. Oh, there you are. You're in, Ferg.
Yep. Just wait so I can see.
I am here.
Dragon Race is not very good at being secret.
Yeah. Worst thing ever.
Yeah. Dude cannot be a ninja. Well, your Mallrat, your profile, your memory profile, right, would have a hash, and then you would basically then hash what it is that needs to get loaded, right, and compare the two. I mean, there has to be some way to do that. There'd be, you know, shorthand or something. Gotta work. okay, so I gotta make me some more bricks. I need 9 bricks, at least. One, two, three, four, five, six, makes 9. And then I want to make some slabs, so that makes another 3. 1, 2, 3. That gives me 12.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Yeah. You're smart, Mallrat. I'm sure you could figure that out, how to do that. And you'd be a hero. Can you imagine if you could make Forge, make it so that when you load Forge, you don't have to reload all the mods again? You'd be a hero. They would cast your image in stone, Mallrat.
I just tried to make juice by clicking the juicer.
You trying to make what?
Tried to make juice by clicking the juicer instead of crafting.
So, I was thinking about making this tank over here. Although, you know, I should make some space around it to connect pipes and stuff, though.
You could also, you know, scoot the platform out and have it in its little area.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, Mallrat, is that it would work almost like a VM, basically. Right? Yeah. Well, I don't know Dragon Race about making it run better, but at least we can make it run faster, or load faster, because it's miserable to sit here watching it load.
Oh, why don't you put it in this big empty space now that we no longer have trees over here?
Yeah, I guess I could. You're right, it is a big empty space. It just seems natural to have it over here, because this is going to be a tank for the cannoli oil.
Ah,
right? And so it just kind of seemed to fit that the canola would be over here, and I was going to have the tank for the canola oil over here, and then all the processing stuff over here.
You could also put it underground underneath the farms.
I could, but I kind of want to see it. You know? That's kind of the fun thing, I think. Although, I mean, I guess we're not really using any of the space down here, are we?
No.
It's just big and empty.
Big and empty.
All right. Why'd you have to make so much sense, Ferg?
Because it scares people.
It catches them off guard, is the thing. They're not expecting that.
Oh my god, he made sense. He thought something through. The world's ending.
So, if I do... Oh, hello. Just became light. I have seen the light.
Well, I figured it was getting kind of dark.
So if I make it over here, and then we leave room for drains. corner. We'll just do a 3x3. That's the minimum size, and that should be plenty. I can't remember how much a 3x3 holds. Something like 1,400 buckets or something like that, I think. I can't remember. A lot.
Why didn't you put it here by your pipes?
Oh, I don't know. I could.
And then you could still see it.
Yeah.
Stop being logical, Ferg. Gonna cause a riot.
You know, here's the deal, is my tendency is to build things as small as possible, right? And so I actually have to force myself to like spread out and build things in different places instead of making them as tiny as possible. And so I was just trying to...
With your efficiency.
I was just trying to spread everything out, basically. Okay, now I need to make a drain. What is it with a drain? I'm going to need like 4 drains. Smeltery drain is 6 bricks. I need 4 of those. Oh man, I used up all my... shoot, the only way to get... Can I get bricks back out of my... Seared bricks? Out of my seared bricks? Now why are those both seared bricks? That's just confusing. So if you take a seared brick, put them together with 3 other seared bricks, you know what you get?
Seared brick.
A seared brick.
It'd be a seared block.
I don't know, they should call it a seared brick block or something like that, right? Or, you know, bonded, mortared bricks or something. Okay, so I can do 1 drain.
You need me to make some more of those?
Well, I mean, yeah, actually, if you wanted to make a few more bricks, just the singles, I need 3 more drains, if you would. That would be great.
Yeah, because I just put cobble in the smeltery, don't I? And then just use the ingot pattern.
Yeah, you know. I didn't know that. People had to tell me that.
I am so smart. S-M-R-T. Why is our cobble gen on?
It shouldn't be. We're full. Oh, I got glass right here.
Oh, that's why it's filling up, because the hopper's full.
Yeah. It's just basically dumping what's still there. Alright, I'm going to put my controller here. Let's see what it takes to make one of those controllers. So did all of you know about this whole Tinker Tank thing? Am I like the last one to hear about it?
I didn't know about it until you were talking about it.
There's one other person. Tinker Tank controller. Oh, so I need some more bricks. Okay, so I need 8 bricks plus the... what do I need? 3 times 6 for the drain. So I need 14 of the single bricks, Ferg.
Okay.
All right.
I am working on that now.
Thank you very much.
I'm helping.
You're going to make a t-shirt like that, right? Helping?
Yep. Yeah. And when I get back from PAX...
You should.
I'm helping. One likes my t-shirt.
Yeah, you got cool shirts.
Probably gonna add it to the mugs too. I'm helping.
I can't fit in there? I guess I should be able to fit in there. Huh. I guess I can't. Why can't I fit in there?
Hold on. Did I not grab my block? Aha.
Oh, I was going to put slabs on the top is what I was going to do. Slabs.
Good evening, gentlemen.
And it's a Craig.
Hey, how you doing, Craig?
Good, how you doing, buddy?
Doing pretty well, thanks. I am,
To crash our stream.
Yeah, stream crusher! No, I am learning how to make a Tinker Tank this evening.
I'm helping.
I'm helping!
And I help. Shake and bake, and I help.
I'm just trying to get redstone. Redstone seems to be our stopping point.
Really?
Yeah. The only way you can get it is sifting.
Yes.
Sunscreen.
Or with these.
But you guys have auto sifting set up, right?
No. Well, I just set it up.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go.
We're grossly behind.
That's okay. So are we. Greylock makes a jetpack for himself and doesn't make one for everyone else.
No.
Oh, mechanism?
Yep. Yeah. You know, I made a jetpack and I showed it off and you guys all kind of poo-pooed it. So I just kind of figured that you didn't want one.
No, we poo-pooed you didn't share.
Oh, I know why that. I bet that's, Oh, that's why. There's those slabs underneath there. All right.
Next week when we all go back together, we should work on making the cyberware things.
Oh, we're gonna cyberdize everyone?
Yeah, cause we got all the we could do like 3 spiders worth of eyes.
I don't know how any of that stuff works.
Yeah, me either.
I played with it a little bit. I took my arms off one time, and that was kind of humorous.
Yeah, you have to be really careful. Once you remove your, like, human parts, you have to make sure you don't lose them, right? Because if you ever decide to go back, that's it. You can't go back unless you've got your old parts.
Yep. And if you don't replace them with anything, you kind of hobble around.
Oh, that's funny.
Like, if you have no arms, you can't use tools or nothing. You can't access anything.
Now I want to disassemble Flame Effect.
That'd be fun.
Alright, I think I've done just about everything I can with the parts and pieces I've got. Actually, I can make some more glass. That's what I can do. I need 3, 6... I need 7 more glass. I'll do that.
I'm just sit here
making bricks. Stuff.
Making bricks. I'm helping. I am finally useful.
Wouldn't go that far, Fred.
Ouch.
Careful there, Craig. Don't make me go to your island. I'll leave you presents.
Oh no.
I will go visit you.
Got any bricks I can have, Ferg?
Yep.
I could use about, I don't know, 12 or so, but I'll take whatever you got. Oh, that's cool. Wow, you've been a busy beaver. Goodness, oh my gosh. Where'd you get all those bricks?
I've been sitting here making them the whole time.
That's crazy.
I made a stack of them. I figured, you know, if you want to make a bigger tank or whatever, we can do that.
Wow. Okay. That's a ton of bricks, dude.
Well, I just threw a stack of cobble in the smeltery. That's what I did. One per cobble. That's almost done. I figure it's better to have many than not enough.
That's true.
It's not like we can't get more cobble.
Oh, I need to cut this out here. There and there and there. Malrat says he was thinking about adding a cane so that if you end up missing a leg, you can still walk around normally.
I want a peg leg.
You want a peg leg? Like a spring-loaded peg leg?
Yeah. No, just a peg leg.
Just peg leg.
So I can just run around and go, arrr, hands. Where you could still, like, access things, but you can't, like, use a sword or something. Now that'd be pretty hilarious.
Alright. Alright, so close, so close. I just need to make the tank controller and a couple of drains. Wow. Alright, thanks, Ferg. That was pretty awesome. That was a ton of bricks, man.
Well, I figure you need them for your tank.
Okay, so I need another drain, which I think was six. I need three of those, actually. Three drains. Uno, dos, and trace. And I gotta make me a controller. Which looks like one of them. It's got a bucket. Get me a bucket. I'm going to be sick.
Okay, I'm gonna go stand over here. Not by my bed.
Have you seen that Mr. Creosote from Monty Python?
Probably, but nope. I don't remember it.
Mr. Creosote, how are you this evening? Better. Better get me a bucket. I'm going to be sick. He's this enormous guy that walks into this restaurant. And, you know, he has this table, you know, piled full of food, and he eats the whole thing.
Oh, yes. Yes, I've seen that. Now
right.
I know.
And then he starts to, like, projectile vomit all over the restaurant, right?
All over the guests and everything, too.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, right. I've got a bucket somewhere in my inventory. I thought I did. Maybe I... Oh, there it is, right there, staring at me. If it's a snake, it would have bit me.
There's a snake in my boot.
There's a snake in my boot. Someone's poisoned the water hole. Finger tank controller. Let's see, this should do the magic right here. I think I've got all the parts and pieces.
Yay, making magic.
I'm going to take this away here so that we can see all the magic. Alright, what do you think? Ready? Here we go. Bing! There it is.
Yay.
How about that, huh? We got ourselves a Tinker Tank. Yeah, that was from Meaning of Life, yeah. We got ourselves a Tinker Tank. Pretty cool, huh?
Tinker Toys! Yay, Tinker Toys!
Alright, so this Tinker Tank will hold 1,250 ignits, which is equivalent to 180 buckets. That is, 180 buckets. Which is a pretty big improvement, because I think we only have, like, two mechanism tanks there, and I think the mechanism tanks are 14 buckets each, something like that, so... This will dramatically improve our cannoli storage. And also I think that with this new version, I think the configuration for advanced generators got updated so that it will accept the crystallized or enhanced, energized, whatever they call it, canola oil. Yeah, fancy.
Fancy.
All right, so we have our tank. That was pretty cool how that worked, thanks to your help, Ferg. Otherwise, I'd still be boring people making seared bricks right now.
So, like my videos, where I run around and accomplish maybe something.
Yeah, no, that's cool.
I spend the whole episode crafting all the stuff I need to make the thing I wanted to make.
Why is it not even put it there?
There
we go. I just want to fill those holes. Replace your divots. Alright, so I've got this here. Now I need to set up the cannoli press and the fermenters I need to do. We've already got two fermenters up there and one cannoli press. So I'll just bring those down here and we can get them set up.
Okay. Better grab your conduits while you're at it, too.
Grab what?
Your conduits.
Oh.
Because if we run out of power, you're not going to be able to grab stuff.
That's true, huh? That's the danger of having everything inside a powered storage system. Alright, so here's our cannoli press. Let me just go ahead and grab that. Here's our fermenting barrel. Grab that and grab that. We still got plenty of juice here in our tank, so we're not going to run out of power anytime soon. We've got 1,400 millibuckets in each one, so 14 buckets in each one, and we got a full tank in the advanced generator anyway.
And we're about just over a million RF, so we should be okay.
Yeah. Well, it does suck it down pretty good, which is why I'm going to be really glad if we can use the enhanced canola in there, because you get a lot more power out of that. Right now, we're actually kind of borderline. I mean, it makes 600 RF per tick, which sounds like a lot, but we burn that down pretty fast, really. Like, when the triplicator is running, it burns through that RF pretty quickly.
Well, that we could also make another one and have this for a backup, and then.
Yeah, well, that's kind of the cool thing about the advanced generator is it's expandable.
Yep.
So you can just keep building on it until your heart's content. And I guess if we move that down here, then we could have a totally huge advanced generator down here. I'd actually forgotten about this little space down here, but we could.
Yay!
That'd be awesome. Okay, so the cannoli press, that comes first, right? And then that goes to the fermenting barrels. So, are you working on something, Ferg? You want to make another canola press, or is there something else you're doing? What's that?
I was just looking at the stuffs.
Oh, okay. Well, you can look at the stuff if you want.
Oh, what drops cactuses?
I think sometimes creepers drop cactus. I think that's a 1.10 thing.
Ah. What was I gonna say? Why are they... Holy crap. What are you? Catalyzed gland. Holy crap. Oh my goodness. We have 461 solid... XP.
461. Oh, really? We need to start using our XPs.
We have plenty of XP.
Yeah, no kidding.
Enchant.
Let's see, the cola press comes actually first. So I want to move this because I want to put the fermenters here. That's what I want to do. Stack them up. And that looks kind of cool. All right. Can I move your bed, Ferg? Are you tied to spawning in this bed?
No, I just put it there.
All right.
Because it's everywhere else was cramped. I'm like, hey, big empty space. I'll stick it here.
I'll just move to the other corner. So we don't really need to up our canola production right now, anyway. But I'm gonna go ahead and make it so we've got like parallel paths. So I want to have like. Two presses, or maybe even we'll go three or four presses and three or four fermenting barrels, so we can crank through a ton of canola if we want to. All right, so I need a bunch of fluid conduits. I did make a second remote for the storage system.
Was in my inventory the whole
time. I should just put your name on that one. What if we can name those? I'll just have to name it Ferg's. Let's see. Fluid conduit.
mine getting really bad. I'm gonna catch
it. Server saves the world. Yay, server!
Oh, wrong one. What am I doing? Not thinking here is my problem. Binder. Binder.
The solderers from refined storage, do they need to be powered from the bottom?
We power ours from the side, just as long as it's next to something that's powered, it should get powered okay.
What am I doing? Why are you not functioning?
I don't have that, so I need to make some more binder. Fortunately, I made a recipe for my binder. Actually, I thought I made just a binder because of just the dust, though. Huh. I'll make another stack of that. That's cool. Start. Thank you. Sorry, just catching up on chat here. Isn't it sand for ex nihilo? I'm not sure what you mean by that, Dragon Racer. Mallrat says, config issue, I want to say, should be cactus seed, not cactus itself. Are you saying, oh, that the creeper should be dropping a cactus seed? Is that what you're saying? That would kind of make sense, wouldn't it?
I'm skeptical. Yay, it finally caught up.
Fingers. Fingers are not working. There it is. Alright, let's start with 19. Let's see what that gets us here. Ferg, where'd you go?
Oh, I'm disconnecting because the server was way behind me.
Oh.
Probably because it's my internet.
Oh, curse you, internets.
Curse you, crappy internets.
Yep.
There, now I can close the door right away. Ah, fixed it!
Let me put that insert. I wonder if this is not going to allow me to connect now. I need to grab a wrench is what I need to do. Because it looks like this is should be out to extract. Always active.
You have a wrench?
No, I need to grab one from upstairs.
I'm upstairs. You want the smart wrench or the Yetta wrench?
The Yetta wrench, please.
Okay. The smart wrench not smart enough for you?
Oh, we can do that. So that's going to be an inserter.
Inserter.
Thank you for the iteration. Sure. All right, how about that? Look at this. We got cannoli oil. Holy cannolis.
Hey, we're doing stuff.
That is extract only. Always active. Extract. No, extract only. Always active. Okay, so we've got our extract working. Now, let's see. Do I have this set up right? This should be in only. This should be extract only. And we'll go ahead and see if we can connect that now. Wrench. Go. See, it's not going to wrench because this already has oil in it, but this is empty now, so I should be able to pull this off and now replace this fluid conduit. Ah, and it's still going there. All right, let's see if I can just now I can wrench it. There, I can wrench it. Okay, good. you know, sometimes you, when you hook up a fluid conduit to something, it grabs that fluid, and it may not be the fluid you want, and then you can't connect the pipes anymore.
Yeah. I hate when that happens.
I hate when that happens. Yeah, that's just part of it. Hmm. Alright, still fermenting away. Alright, we have 173 buckets? Does that sound right? Oh, use 6 buckets. Yeah, I did that. Didn't sound right. Okay. Space for 173 more buckets. So, Craig, what are you working on?
Trying to figure out refined storage. I cannot get this solderer to hook up to my extra utilities generators.
Oh, really? Okay, yeah. You know what? I deliberately stayed away from the XU power because it uses that grid power, right?
The generators don't unless you put in a upgrade.
Okay. So then just on their own by default, they just produce RF. Is that right?
Right.
Oh, okay.
Depending on, yeah, whichever one. We're going with slime power.
Nice.
I've seen your giant skyscraper you've made.
Cool. Sounds good.
I have more slime than I know what to do with. And more power than I know what to do with.
Yeah. Well, if I don't know if you're in a position to see my stream right now, but this is our refined storage setup.
What are you using for power conduits?
Ender.io.
Well, see, that's what I couldn't get it to hook up at all.
But I don't think I've even got it connected back here. See, actually, it won't connect.
It's powering the controller, and then the controller's powering everything adjacent.
Yeah.
Okay, so I just need a controller.
Yes.
Easy peasy.
Yeah, there's RS power is a special kind of power for everything. So you power the controller, and then it turns it into the refined storage power units, and then everything else works off that refined storage. So they either have to be contiguous to receive refined storage power, or you have to use the special refined storage cables to get them all talking together and pass power.
Controller acquired.
There you go. That should get you there. Okay, well, while I'm here, I'm going to make another cannoli press. And we're squeezing cannolis like crazy.
Yay!
Canola press. Oh, man, we have to get all crazy here with these funky crystals. Inori crystals. Let's see if we have some of those already. Oh, we do! Bada-bing, bada-boom! That's one of the cool things about having the refined storage system is you just drop the recipe in and if you've got it, it'll put it in there for you, and you don't have to even guess or go searching for those bits and pieces.
I'm just tired of having chests everywhere.
Oh, I know, right?
Hey. I always have chests everywhere. Them are fighting words.
Whoa, got a little lag there from when the tree farm kicked off. Wow.
Yeah, I was bored.
Oh, is that you? Did you like manually trigger it or something?
Yep. I figured I'd help get some wood.
He's helping.
I'm helping. I'm helping a lot. I'm winning the race.
All right.
We got about now 7 stacks of wood in there. So.
Yeah. Cool.
Figure we can always use more wood.
Alrighty. You know, I had thought, and this is about wrenches, I had thought that wrenches were kind of universal anymore, that all of them kind of talk to each other, but that's not the case, is it?
Nope.
Not in 1.10.
Yeah. No. Yeah. I thought basically, you know, you have one wrench, whether it be your Yetta or configurator or whatever, and that would basically do it for everything, but that has not been my experience. We're kind of back to, you know, one wrench per mod kind of a thing.
Ah, so we've gone back to the 1.25.
Yeah.
1.2 day. Five
right.
Days.
Okay, what would be a good storage? Because I thought I would have just a dedicated cannoli storage down here. I could do
a storage drawer.
Storage drawer, you think? Yeah.
Well, if you're just gonna have the cannolis down here, one item, then that's probably your best bet.
Yeah, probably, huh?
We'll keep things simple.
Yeah. Well, I like the storage drawers. I like that it's all visual. And there's not like any GUI or anything. You just kind of, you know, click on it and it does its thing. I like
yeah,
that.
I was sad in VC3. I never got my railcard system set up.
Yeah, there's a lot more to be done there, really. I got busy elsewhere doing some other things and I couldn't participate as much as I wanted to, but I had some big plans for doing stuff.
I obviously did.
Yeah. That is true.
I had set my base up for the long haul. Yeah, just getting to the point where nobody was on and just issue after issue was cropping up. So.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Oh, we had a big tree spawn. I think we're going to want a limiter, like a little slab up there to keep the really big trees from spawning. You see what happened over there
well,
in the tree farm?
Yep. Well, if I had a jetpack, I would have fixed it.
Yeah.
We're going to nominate you the tree fixer now, since you made the jetpack. You have to fix our tree.
There we go. Oh, I should have, actually, we should need to, put a slab up, 5 or 6 spaces up or something. I do have a slab. How high up do you suppose it should be? Oh. I can't put, I was gonna tower up to about 5 or 6 spots up, but every time I do
the thing would kick on.
The thing kicks on and takes it out. Isn't there an on-off switch? There we go. All right. I wonder how high it goes. So there's like a thing where it shows you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Where is that? Here. Preview mode. That's it. Oh, but it won't let you in. It's actually solid.
Yeah.
That's not very helpful. I can't go in to add, like, blocks to it now.
You can set the block on top.
Actually, I guess I could. Yeah, all right.
Oop. There you go, overthinking again.
I know. Well, just put that right about here, I think. Oh.
I don't know. Yeah. Mistakes were made.
It just turned off automatically. I don't know what the deal was there. Oh, see, that wasn't high enough because it still took it out.
Oh, wow.
I put it on top of the little shield area and it still took it out.
Well, I guess we can't put a block up there. You set it on top, or did it go in?
Okay, well, that's weird. When I place a block on the top, the whole little shield area disappears.
Ah.
That seems like maybe some sort of a bug, maybe?
Shift and put it on?
I can figure it out by putting it over here like this.
Just going across.
Yeah.
Well, I can pretty this up later.
Let's see, I think. Is this it? No, right there, that's it. Yeah, that's it. Okay, now we turn that off. There we go. That seems really high. I don't think that's going to stop a large tree from spawning, personally. But okay.
Well, I don't know. This is a creature's thing.
Yeah. Well, but I guess it had to have been that high, right? That had a really big tree. Did they actually grow that big? That would have been a really large tree. Be
I
really...
believe I can fly.
Yep, that really worked. Let me fly.
All right, where was I here? So I need to power this up, and I need to get our cannolis flowing. The cannoli must flow. We've got our power bus going around here. Should I deliver it on the back? Do that. All right, so we have powered presses now. All right, so I need to get my cannolis coming down. Oh, I put storage on it. That's what I need to do. I was going to put storage, and I got distracted by that tree shenanigans going on up top up there. But first, a carrot juice. This carrot juice... brought to you by Mott's Fresh Juices. All right, so storage drawers. Do we have any extra storage drawers that you made when you made your wall of drawers over there?
Yep, there's one in here.
One single,
what you need.
Perfect. Just like you knew. How did you know? A basic drawer.
As the end of VC2, I'm the shenanigans fairy.
Alright. Unless you can think of something more fun than, you know, using drawers. You need to be kind of nice if there's some sort of a, like, almost like a tank kind of a thing. Like a huge bin.
Item tank?
An item tank. Yeah, it'd be like a giant bin. You know, like a... like a corn crib kind of a thing, but for items, right?
Yep.
That would be kind of cool. Have I got cannoli with me? I thought I had cannoli. There it is. Alright, so now we've got our cannoli drawer. 64 cannolis in it. And I need some item conduits. Look at that. I increased the range on our remote, by the way, too. Modular storage. That sounds familiar, but I don't remember modular storage. Is there modular storage in this pack?
Isn't that the RF tools one?
Yeah, you're right. That is called modular storage. That's right, yeah.
Yeah, that's what we're using.
Mm.
Well, up until just now.
Yeah, okay, so modular storage, right. So that actually works a whole lot like refined storage, just with the drives and everything. But I'm looking for something more industrial looking. Dragon Racer had suggested modular storage.
It's much cheaper.
Yeah, it's cool though. I really like the system. VC, what's that?
For the robo-surgeon to add the parts,
yep.
You need 3 diamond tools.
Oh.
Yeah, that's why I stopped playing with ads.
Pretty pricey.
have the power scanner.
I've had mine going to town on a spider eye for like the last half hour and it hasn't done anything with it. Oh, I got a blueprint.
Oh, nice.
I have no idea what I'm doing here. Put that there. Ooh, scanner. Is this thing? Can I place this anywhere? Ooh! Engineering table.
Oops, I'm gonna do that.
Who let Ferg play with the body parts?
That sounds like nothing good can come of this.
Surgery chamber.
All right, so we've got that set up. Well, if that were set up, shouldn't we be able to... What if I need to do a separate channel for that, then? I bet I do. That's not going to feed that. Because it doesn't make requests. It would work. That would work for logistics pipe, so it's not going to work for Ender.io, though. I need to do a separate system like this. And that will strictly extract. Always active, we'll make that green, doesn't really matter. That's always insert, we'll make that green, that's always insert. There we go, that's working. All right, so then, I don't need this then. And that, it only needs to go there, and that feeds that, cool. All right, well, thanks for popping in, Dragon Racer. Appreciate it. Have a good day tomorrow. Okay, so I've got the cannoli storage feeding the cannoli presses. Now I need to get... I've got the fluid coming out of the press going to the fermentation barrels. So now I need to actually get my canola storage hooked up to the farmer up here. And that is up here somewhere. Over here. Oof, fell back down again. All right, so what I want to do is take the line that goes to the chest and bypass that, move it over to our other storage instead.
Ah.
Aw.
Hee.
So pull that and pull that. And we'll have it go over this way instead. So, Craig, did you get your refined storage working? The soldering station?
Yes.
Nice.
Yes. I've got 4 1K drives almost filled up with just, like, crafting materials.
Really? Oh, wow.
Well, to be fair, most of it is copper, because there's just ample quantities of that for no reason.
Yeah, we don't really use much copper. Why did that do that? I don't really do that. Why is that letting me connect that? I got that going there. Oh, I've already got it in there, that's why. I actually don't want in out. I want that to be insert on the yellow channel. And that should be good, because I think, let me just double check up here. I think my canola seeds are coming in on the yellow channel.
Oh, we have diamond block.
Oh, they come out on green, that's why. Oh, I thought they're on yellow. Oh, the yellow came out of the chest, that's what it was. So I need to flip that over to green channel. All right, so this needs to be on green channel then. So let's flip that over to green. And look at that, the canola is flowing. All right, so right now I've got canola flowing from my farmer into our storage, which is feeding our presses, which is feeding our fermentation barrels. Ooh, but I'm only feeding one fermentation barrel.
Good job, Ferg.
Yay! Doing stuff.
You're playing Minecraft.
Yay! Playing Minecraft. I'm doing stuff. Everyone's gonna be very upset with me, but I don't care.
Always active, always active.
Ha!
Why is that empty? That one's empty too. That one's full of
what?
Canola. What are you saying, Ferg?
What is empty?
Oh, I'm just wondering why my canola press isn't delivering the oil to the fermenting barrels right now. It's set to extract, and it's full. That one's full. Oh, I bet it is. It's just that it's draining. Like, if I were to turn this off here. Or maybe not. No? Yeah, okay, there's some coming through the pipe. Why am I not seeing it come out here? So that's full. But it's not coming out. Extract, always active. Alright, what am I missing here? I'm not sure what I'm missing here. Maybe just try resetting it, maybe, and see if that helps. That's set to insert, and that's set to insert. There's nothing going in, nothing coming out. Those are full. So they should be extractinating. And I swear it was extractinating, but now it's not. All right, well, let's just pull it apart and see what happens. Boop, boop, boop. We'll do that and that. I'm not sure what I'm missing here. In, out, extract, always active. There's a fluid conduit. And it's full of fluid. The barrels can pull from any side. I thought for sure it was actually going in, but maybe not. All right, well, I am befuddled here with these fermenting barrels. They're, the fluid's not flowing between them. I'm missing something here.
I wasn't paying attention. What's going on now?
Oh, I'm just trying to move fluid from my canola press over to my fermenting barrel through an Ender.io fluid conduit. and it's not flowing. That's exactly the way we had it set up upstairs, but it's not working now, and I'm befuddled as to what's going on here. It's pretty straightforward, right? You extract out of one side and insert in the other, but it's just not going through.
Does it have to go in down on the top?
Yeah, well, maybe. Let me try that and see.
Do they act as one when you stack them like that?
No, uh-uh. Oh. They don't. I just wanted to stack them up just so it looks kind of cool.
That would be really cool if it did. Someone call LPAC.
Yeah.
That would be awesome.
Okay, so let's just we'll just set this to disable, and we'll set that to insert, and still nothing's going in. Yeah,
I've been having a lot of auto input issues with some of my machines the last couple days too.
Well, you know, the odd thing was is we had the same setup upstairs up here, and it was working just flawlessly. Let me take a look at what's up here still. If there's any remnants, might give us any clues. Not really.
I was fiddling for an hour with Ender IO conduit, item conduits last night in my slime farm.
Yeah.
Trying to get them going into a autocrafter from RF Tools.
Mm-hmm.
And I had them going in there just fine, and then I moved the cables around and nothing worked.
Huh.
And I ended up having to disassemble everything,
yeah,
back down, and it was fine.
Crazy.
Yeah, try breaking the fermenter and just replacing it. See if that fixes it.
Okay, so it works from the top ones. I wonder if it's like a gravity thing. Because, you know, these unpressurized ones, they won't go up very far. But I know I've used it going up just like a couple of blocks before. It didn't seem to bother it. But when I hooked it up to this top one, right, it just flowed like it's supposed to.
That's so weird.
Yeah. I can use the pressurized one, I guess. You know, but... All right, so that works. Now, let me...
think they introduced gravity.
Yeah, well, these, the just the normal fluid conduits won't go up very far. To do that, you need the next step up, which is a pressurized fluid conduit, I think they call it.
I thought it was just the difference of volume that it would...
Well, I know, I'm pretty sure that's the way it works. Yeah, the pressurized fluid conduit. Yeah, so on the fluid conduit, if you do the little shift description thing, it says fluid flow respects gravity. Flow rate dependent on fluid viscosity.
The more you know.
But I thought it'd be good for like one block, moving one up one block. All right, so I guess for this, it's strange, but I guess I'll have to make the pressurized one. Or I can put them up. Oh, you know what I'll do is I'll put the storage underneath, and then that'll bump up the fluid presses so that they'll be above the barrels then. A lot of work. Do that. I'll break this. I'll remove that, and remove this, and... Boy, I can tell when that tree farm works. Or was that maybe the light going on? Yeah, that's what it was. Something lags it out. I'm all full of parts and pieces here. Oh my gosh, where all these pieces come from? Alright, canola press goes up here, and now storage goes below. Get rid of some of our cannolis. And okay, so that then will come out this way. So that way we can go fluid conduit there in, oh, stop. Extract only. Yeah, you know, I knew that it was affected by gravity, but I had never had a problem before. Oh, gosh. Had just on like a one block like that. So I wonder, it says something about viscosity. So I wonder if maybe that's why, because this is oil.
That could be. I'll have to remember that when I get back into my single player stuff when we get back. Because I'm in my single player world, I'm doing the exact same thing you're doing right now.
Yeah.
And I'm not very good at it.
Oh. Now every time I pop this conduit on, it fills with fluid. And then it won't connect. Here we go. I'll just have to drain it first. I gotta wait for that to drain. Bloop, 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 bloop. Well, that was weird. Like I said, I'd never had a problem with that before.
Can't go into smeltery.
Yeah, that is kind of a bummer. Drained yet? There it is. Drained. Okay, so now I should be able to connect this if I wrench it off. Stick that back on there. Now I can connect it. There we go. Alright. That should have been really easy and it wasn't. But now it's working. It's all good. Alright, that's extracting, that's extracting, that is inserting. We've got 100, oh, we got 15 buckets in there. Cool. Okay, I need to do something. Oh, that's right, I need to add my item conduits after moving the stuff around. Maybe there's something I was forgetting here. Fluids we're done with, power we're done with. Items, we gotta put that there. I don't think that wants to go there. No, it also has to go here. So I don't want that to connect. everything comes down, goes to storage, and then from storage, it will extract out of there and go into insert. All right, cool. So what do we have here? We have 104 here, and that is staying full, and that has none. Why does that have none? That is set to extract. That's why it's set to extract. That needs to be an insert. And I did have a filter for this where it's just canola. I probably don't need that, but we'll put that there just in case. Why is that not filling? This one is, and it's insert on green. That's why it's set to extract. Insert on green, priority 0. There we go. Okay. All is well. All right. How are we doing our canola supplies up here? What are you working on, Ferg?
The billion dollar man.
Are you cyberneticizing right now? Are you?
I am.
Oh no. Scary monsters.
I forgot how to work it.
Alright, so if I had problems moving this canola oil just up one block, I wonder what's going to happen to this at this tank. I'm going to need to use a pressurized conduit for sure then, to take it all the way from the tank all the way up there. For sure. Alright, fingers. Tight for me. Alright, so that is just, I need fused quartz with that, or, that's interesting. So I can either use 3 fused quartz, or 2 fused quartz, and a fluid conduit. That's kind of nice that you can recycle your fluid conduit. Okay, so, to do that, I'm going to need to move a pressurized fluid conduit all the way from hither to yon. That's a pretty good stretch. Let's see if I've got happen to have any of that. I do. Alright. There can be no justice. 16. Let's get another 8. Oh, ran out of conduit binder of all things. While that's cooking, well, I guess it's already got 6. I can make some. Do one of these. Oh, I'm missing the glass is what I'm missing. The fused quartz. That's nether quartz in there. Which I'm using for that right now. Get rid of some of this stuff. I got way too much stuff. when I go in building mode, I start to get all kinds of clutter.
Yep.
Alright, let's see if I got me some... Oh, silicon? Oh man, did I do that wrong? I wanted to get glass out of that. How did I do wrong? I needed to make fused quartz. I thought I put another quartz in there. Oh, I know what it is. I had it in the wrong mode. Dang it. That's what it was.
Always the worst.
I know. And I've done that so many times, too. I got a stack of silicone out of it, though. All right, so I don't want it to be in furnace mode. I want it to be all smelting. I mean, it's handy that the alloy smelter does both smelting and furnace until you put it in the wrong mode. Okay, that should get me there, I think. So now I have to pump this fluid, the oil from the tank. I wonder if I can do the tinkers. You can't do a drain at the on the top of a tinker tank, can you?
I don't know.
And it has to come at the bottom.
Oh, tank. Those I'm not too sure.
I'm gonna check that out and see what happens here. Do I still have one? I just any more bricks left? No, I don't. Where's my remote? I just dropped all my seared bricks back in the storage after complaining about having too much stuff. Alright, well, let's see if I can do this. If I pop this out, do that, put a brick in. Now, can I put a... drain up there. That would be cool if I could do that, but I don't think it's going to let me put a drain up top, but I'll let you know. Oh, I put it in. Oh, it looks like it's working too. Oh, now let's see if I can actually drain out of there. It let me put a drain up there, although, to be honest, it kind of made my tank ugly. It looks better when it's down below. What am I going to do here? What if I can put it up in the top? Let's check that out. I do that and do that. And then put my drain here and put glass there. Oh yeah, it's still active. All right, that works. That's pretty cool. So then I can do this. All right, nice. And I can say extract, always active, and it's hard to tell if it's anything in there. The pressurized, I don't see anything there. No, it must be because it won't connect up, so. Cool. All right. That way it still looks good, too. Nice. Alright. See how it looks from over here. Yeah, I can't really tell too much. You know what I'll do is I'll put some wood slabs around the sides anyway, make it match. Oh wow, something just lagged me up.
Not me.
No, I think it may be either the tree farm or... I don't think it's the floodlights turning on, but I don't know. I just took a hit all of a sudden there. Alright, now let's start laying some pipe. We've got our own Dakota pipeline going here. Not to get political or anything.
Picked a good day to not go political.
Yeah. No kidding.
Yeah. Okay, so this needs to go to... Oh, our power's over... Where is our power? Right there. Alright. I might have just enough pressurized conduit. Oh, hello.
I'm becoming the bionic.
I'm afraid. Genuinely afraid.
You and me both.
Okay, so I've got the pressurized conduit going in to the generator, and I think I've got that set on yellow because that's the oh, doesn't matter, I guess, for inserting. It just inserts. That's interesting. So, oh, that's right, because fluid, you can't really do that. You can't have channels for fluid. Okay. All right, so that's going in, and there was one spot where it wasn't connected yet. That was over here somewhere. Where was it? It was right here, I think. Well, sometimes when you've got a whole bunch of conduits overlaid, it can be really difficult seeing where you need to smack it to get it to connect.
Hold on your shift while you have your Yetta wrench in your hand.
Yeah?
And then scroll.
Oh, that's interesting.
It changes which one you're going to be looking at specifically.
Yeah. Interesting. Huh. All right, that's kind of cool. All right. Do that. Hello. Okay, so then... When I scrolled it, now it's... Oh, see, I ran out of... That's what it was. I ran out of pressurized fluid conduit. That's what it was. I'm like, one... No, I should have enough. It's just not connecting as all. So I just gotta smack it then.
Yep.
There we go.
And it won't hit anything else while you're in the fluid conduit mode. Like, it ignores all the other ones.
Yeah. But it looks like it's not connected... Maybe it is.
Oh, I think that junction just looks weird, maybe?
Yeah. Well, I guess the proof will be whether or not the fluid is flowing here. Well, this is full, so it must be working.
It's really weird looking, though.
It is, yeah. The connection, it doesn't look like it should be connected. It looks like it's kind of like overlapping or something, right?
Yeah.
Right, that little bit sticking out right there? Yeah, that doesn't look right. Although, yeah, I'm not sure what happened with that. Guess I could pop it off and replace it and see what happens. Fluid, pressurized fluid. And then, boop, but now it's not connected. So I can connect it here and connect it here, yeah, it does the same thing. Huh, odd. Just one of those things, I guess. Alright, so that's got 17 buckets of oil in it, and right now we're not really pulling any juice. We need to maybe we'll get Vaygrim bot working here so we can be pulling some juice. All right, that's cranking through. So we should be pulling some power now. Alrighty. So many canola seeds. Delete, 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 delete. I see you running around out there, Ferg, but I'm scared to see what you've become.
I am nothing.
I need to wait for the power to cycle on so I can see if it's going to fill up okay. Or I guess I could just turn it on. Didn't that just turn it on though? Yeah, there you go. The light just didn't come on, I guess. So it's producing a little bit, not a bunch, but a little bit. Making a little bit of a draw. Not much though. We just need to get some materials flowing through the triplicator. That's what we need to do. Maybe we'll get Vaygrim working on dusts. Although we don't really need dusts, but.
Well, gentlemen, I think I am out for the night.
Okay.
Alrighty. Thanks for popping into the chat, Craig.
No problem. Thanks for hanging out with me.
All right. Catch you later.
All right. See you guys.
What are you doing, Ferg?
Going, keep going. What's it look like?
I don't know. I don't know what to think. I'm gonna start making dusts, I guess. Okay. Oh, there we go. I see sand going in there. All right, we're grinding, and why are we not doing any sand in here?
All right. Well, I can see in the dark.
You can, yeah?
Yep. Holy crap!
Oh no, what?
Can't use the ladder now. Go use this ladder.
I'm afeared. I'm afeared, Ferg.
Ah, I couldn't add all the stuff I wanted.
You just run out of spaces to cyberneticize?
Yep. But I can run faster now, I think.
Alright, well, this has got to be working because it's been generating power and it's still got 17,000. Millibuckets in there. We've got 30 buckets of oil to our account. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and set this back to automated again. Enable fuel use. So that should start shutting down. There it is, preserving fuel. Cool. Let's see. This should be empty because it's sending all of the canola down to the storage here. We should have a bunch of in storage. It actually says, let's say none? No, there's no canola in here right now. Could that be right? I guess I can add a bunch of canola here. Oh, you glassed off that. All right, that's fine.
Glassed off what?
Oh, the override for the farmer. You used to be able to actually look at the sign and flip that switch, but you can't anymore because there's glass there. But that's cool. That's fine. There we go. Okay, the drawer was empty, and I wanted to make sure that it was still working properly. I think I'm gonna leave it on for a little bit to accumulate some canolas again. Get rid of some of this yunk. Binder back there, put our conduits away.
See if this actually worked.
See if what works?
I'm supposed to be able to run faster.
Oh, you want to do a little competition?
Yeah. Nice wide spot, it's long enough.
Alright. Say when.
Set, go.
Oh yeah.
I can run. I can outrun everyone. I'm the bionic man. That's about all. I can see in the dark. Should put a...
You know, I'm not sure if you look.
He started working on it over here.
I'm not sure if your avatar looks any different or not because you kind of had that glowy stuff on before. But you're.
Nope.
Oh, you're not. Yeah, you don't look any different.
Well, I don't have any cybernetic parts on me. I didn't realize Preach was over here working on stuff.
Oh.
Because I built that. I built the box. I built some of the same things.
Oh, somewhere else, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he had started to build a setup over here.
Well, I can go grab mine. Because I actually built the thing so it works.
Where is your cybernetic setup?
I hit it.
You hit it?
No, I just didn't know where there was power, so I just built it back here.
Oh, gotcha. Oh, you hit it behind the triplicator. Very sneaky. No one's going to look over there.
I know, right?
That's funny, because I was busy over here. I didn't even know you were over there.
Yep. Ah, well.
Isn't there on storage drawers? There's a way to put like, oh, that's only with the master controller though. Isn't there a way to put like all of your, the whatever you're holding? Like if I want to put all this canola in at one time.
Double click.
That's what I thought.
Ball already? Should be able to. You have to access the front of it. I know that. Do that.
No, it's not doing it. Oh, double right click. That's what it is. That's what it is. Double right click. I knew there was a way of doing it. I just couldn't think of what it was. Okay. Oh, well. Nearly fell.
I have all the power.
All right, so now we've got about almost 2,000, just shy of 2,000 canola in there. Well, I'm pretty impressed with the Tinker tank, how flexible it is. I was able to actually put the drain for it all the way at the top.
Yeah.
Placing there. Okay, it's gonna be what it's gonna be. Okay. Well, I think that I might be done for the night. So I've basically what I've done is I've moved all of our canola production downstairs so that I've put two systems in parallel so that we can be producing twice as much oil as we were before, and we're up to 30 buckets of oil in storage right now, which is already more than what our previous storage was. Our previous storage was 28 buckets total, and so we're already at 30, almost 31, and we've got a capacity for I think 150 buckets. 180 buckets actually.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's plenty of fuel. So if something goes wrong or whatever and the system gets disconnected, we'll still have a lot of fuel to keep our base powered. And also, we're going to we're going to start pulling more power for things and stuff. So we're going to end up needing more fuel production. But next step will be to take a look at how to use the enhanced fuel. But we've got enough space down there that we'll be able to convert the canola seeds to the enhanced seeds. I can't remember what they're called, energized or something like that. Let's see if I can find it here. Canola. It is the crystallized canola seed and then the empowered canola seed. So the crystallized canola seed, you, looks like you zap it with the atomic reconstructor and it becomes the crystallized. And then to make the energized, or sorry, the empowered, it takes, I'm not sure how this works. With the empowerer, it takes four canola seeds and a crystallized canola seed to make one empowered canola seed.
Okay.
So, yeah, so we'll have to figure out how to automate the empowerer for actually additions. I know there's a way to do it. I've just never done it before. So, yeah, I think that's progress. So we've got we've increased our storage. We've made ourselves more flexible, so we can now go to the more advanced canola oil systems. And
oh my goodness.
What?
I added a mob targeter. I can see you through the floor.
Yeah? Well, I can see you just by seeing where your nameplate is.
Yeah, but I see your whole outline, jetpack and all.
Really? That's either very cool or very distracting. Can you turn it on and off? No.
Wait. Hold on, controls.
Oh. No.
I've got something conflicting with the key.
Oh.
Nope. Oh yeah, I can disable everything.
Oh yeah. Can you just turn the targeting on and off though, or can you just turn the whole thing, the whole system on and off?
I can turn everything.
Individually.
Yep. Like the HUD jack, the targeting overlay.
Yeah.
Because.
Now, why is that accumulating here? I wonder if that's full already. How much can a storage drawer hold, you know?
2048, so...
Yep, full. Alright.
Oh my goodness, it shows me what everything in the chest, too. This is freaking awesome. I like this targeting overlay.
That could be cool, actually. So you can actually see what's inside of chests?
Normal, quarry, clearing... Y level, it tells me what it's doing, what chunk it's in.
Well, yeah, but I can see that.
From, oh, on the mode normal quarry?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought it was just that it was something new. Oh, I could see all the mobs in our mob farm, too.
That's cool.
All the critters. All the critters are outlined.
Yeah. That's cool. Alrighty. Well, yeah, so that's cool. So that was my task for this evening, was to get us onto the a more powerful, more flexible system, and it looks like we're there, and we got ourselves this really cool tinker tank. I learned how to use the Tinker's Construct tank, and I'm pretty impressed with it. It's really flexible. You move the drains around, of multiple drains. You can make it really just about any size. It gets to be huge. I guess maybe I could have put this somewhere where there's more room to expand. We could... I guess I could always take it out another. Yeah, I could take it another couple blocks in each direction, so I can actually just about triple its size from what it is right now, just by expanding it out a couple of blocks in each direction. Alrighty, so I think I'm gonna call the stream there. I've got done my task. Thanks for your help, Ferg, for kicking out those seared bricks. I don't know how you got the seared bricks kicked out so fast. It seems like I was staring at them for an hour, making them one at a time.
I had somebody to talk to, so I'm now the bionic person.
Yeah. look at you go. So how does that work? Do you have to like recharge? Okay. You make me dizzy.
Well, we got there's cardio, there's different power order systems you can put in. Like, I got a... By eating food, it recharges it.
Yeah.
Also, I added the solar skin, so I just sit out in the sun and it recharges itself.
Wait, you have solar skin?
Yep. I'm solar powered. Hear me. Also, I added the HUD so I know what everything is. So.
Yeah.
So I just sit out in the sun for a minute and all of a sudden it's recharging.
Bask in the sun. Spare Ferg parts. Ooh, dude, your muscles and eyes and stomach are in here. Okay, that's icky.
Yep.
That's icky.
I figured I wanted to keep those in a safe spot.
Too funny. You know, we need to maybe think about doing some, maybe have a little beautification product project, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
I was looking at some other islands and on their Let's Plays, and we've got a whole lot of cobble. They have, like, nice stone and stuff. You know, chiseled.
I started with your greenhouse.
You did, yeah. You did a great job on the greenhouse. Yeah.
I made it way better than all their crap.
Alrighty, well, we're at, oh gosh, it's 2.5 hours on the stream. Wow, where did the time go? That's going to be a lot of fun to upload.
Yeah.
Any guesses how long it's going to take to upload that? Oh, that's going to be a pretty good sized chunk of data.
Oh, yeah.
Alrighty, well, we're going to cut the stream here. This keeps timing out on me. What keeps timing out on you? Beam keeps timing out on you, Mallrat? What are you working on? Mallrat is not responding. He must mean Beam. I wonder if Beam is timing out on him. Network errors. Oh, weird. Very weird. Alrighty. Well, hey, thanks for watching. Appreciate it. This will be available on Beam as a video on demand pretty much immediately after I stop the stream. Last time, it was kind of funny. I didn't tell anybody this, but last time I forgot to stop the stream. And so, you know, I just kind of went on, was doing other things. And then I go to, dude, you're scaring me. You're scaring me. I go to do other things and I go look at Beam and the video on demand should be there and it's still not there. And so I actually, like, you know, opened up a little service ticket with Beam saying, you know, what's going on, that the VODs are taking forever to post and whatever. So meanwhile, like an hour later, I realized that OBS is still streaming to Beam. And at that point, yeah, I just sort of quietly, humbly just, you know, turned off the stream, and sure enough, the VOD appeared right away. So it was like, you know, almost like a 4-hour VOD or something like that. It was kind of crazy. That was quite a chunk to download. So this time I'm going to watch and make sure that I actually stop the stream here. So anyway, thanks for watching. This will be available on Beam, video on demand, immediately. Give it a couple of days. Actually, considering PAX, I'm going to try to get it up on the YouTubes before I go to PAX, but no promises there. So ordinarily, it would be up on YouTube in a couple of days, but just considering work schedule and I fly out to PAX Thursday afternoon, that's not a lot of time to prep that kind of stuff, but I'll see what I can do. So anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll do this again next Tuesday. I do it usually, Ferg and Dark Preacher and I are on here Tuesday evenings, 8 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. Central. Ferg, what are you working on other than the Vaygrim's Chance for Life in the Buffer? What other projects are you working on?
I have that. I have my building with Ferg. I have started a vanilla Ark Survival Evolve. And Squishy Socks.
Squishy Socks. Are you still working? You're still working on the Squishy Socks project?
Yeah, I started on Oblivion after I couldn't kill anything in Morrowind.
Gotcha.
Like, things would not die. I'd just sit there and swing my sword in their general direction right in their face, and they'd just one shot me.
Very cool. Alrighty. So be sure to check out Ferg's projects as well. Ferg, where's what's the your YouTube channel? Is it just Fergcraft?
It is Fergosaurus Rex.
Fergosaurus Rex on the YouTube.
If you want to see some my really old stuff, then yeah, it's on Fergcraft.
Right. All right. Well, again, thanks for watching, and we'll do this again next week. Be watching for this to go up on YouTube. And while you're there on YouTube, check out my Let's Play. I'm currently going through the Planet Explorers, which is a sandbox slash RPG. I think I'm at episode 18 now on Planet Explorers, and I'm probably only halfway through the story mode, but I'm having a lot of fun with that. So thanks a lot for watching, and have a good evening. We'll catch you next time.